Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be answering a question from Matt's, who asks, how can I cut a tube in a 45 degree segment? I've created a tube here in Sketchup already, and there are a few different ways that you can actually cut a tube in Sketchup. So I'm going to show you those three, starting with maybe the most obvious, and then go from there. So if I was in here and I wanted to make a 45 degree cut, the first thing I would do would be to make a group of that tube and then make another object that essentially we're going to use to slice our tube. So I'm going to rotate, press Q here to bring up the rotate tool and rotate this face 45 degrees. I'm not going to be too careful about how I move this. I'm just going to move it so that it intersects the tube. As long as it is fully covering that tube, I'm good. So the next thing up here in the toolbar, I have, it's called the solid tools. If you don't have this, you just right click in an open space and you want to make sure that solid tools is checked. Now, the third button from the top right, that is actually the subtract tool. And in the bottom left, you can see that it says subtract first solid from second and keep only the result of the in the model. So that's what we want to do. So we will select the first, we'll subtract from. So we want to select our object and then the tube, and this is the result. So pretty simple, but involved some grouping of both, and it gets rid of our shape that we used to subtract from. So certainly an effective method, but maybe not the best. The second way, we're just going to make a plane here. So I'm going to press R for the rectangle tool and then Q to rotate this 45 degrees. Obviously, this could be any angle you wanted, but we're using 45 degrees for this example. Place it so that it's intersecting that plane. I'm going to select all of these. Control A to select all, since it's the only thing in my model. Right click. Go to intersect faces with selection, and what that's going to do is essentially slice this tube because it's ungrouped, and then our plane that is selected is grouped, so it's not going to actually do anything to that. And then we can use the eraser tool with E to erase the extra objects. But you can see here the end is actually not filled in. And if you draw a line on the outside, it just makes a full circle. So you actually have to draw a second line on the inside and then delete it if you want your end to be capped, essentially. So super effective and fast, probably the fastest until you get up to the very end where you need to fill in that shape. So if you don't need to do that, if you're combining two shapes, like two pipes that are at 45 degree angles, maybe it makes sense to do it this way. And then the last way is using a plugin. And I'm just going to say full disclosure here, this plugin costs $15. And I don't get anything if you buy it. It's made by a plugin creator who makes a ton of plugins, whose name is Enneroth. I think that's how you say her name. I'm not 100% sure, so sorry if I said it wrong. But basically, this will let you do it in, I think, the quickest way and easiest. It's $15, but she makes so many awesome plugins, or I guess they're actually called extensions. So many awesome extensions. I was like, you know what? She deserves at least $15 from me because she's helped me so much through all of her awesome plugins. So with this, you're going to do the same thing you sort of did last time and make that plane. But the big difference here is that you don't need to intersect it with the tube. So we're going to just position this in and then make a copy of it and flip it along the red axis. For some reason, it doesn't seem to actually work when I do it the first time. So I'm just actually going to rotate it and just figure out a workaround for that. So rotate this 180 degrees, then push it in. And it doesn't actually have to be even in the same plane as the tube, which is kind of cool. So I'm going to move this off to the side, and you could use this as a reference for basically anything. Those two planes will let you cut anything. So what I did is I selected that and then moused over to the alignment angle using the mouse and then held shift and made my cut. So super awesome that I can just do that so quickly. And you could even move it to be the other side just as quickly. You know, let's say I cut it in the wrong direction, and that is so incredibly helpful. Like, I love the way that this tool works. So it's called Enroth Align Faces. It's you can get it through the extension warehouse, and like I said, it's $15. I don't get anything for saying that. I just think if you use her stuff, I would totally recommend buying it. So but that's that. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.